Good morning. It's great to see so many of you here. For some reason, Christina always asks me to come along when we're supposed to disrupt things. But hopefully we will be able to do that. And I dare say that during the next hour, we will be able to change your concept of how this world works. Because demographics affects everything under the sun, virtually everything. And there is one man who is really the expert on the subject, and it gives me great pleasure to introduce Mr. Amlan Roy, who is the Managing Director and Head of Global Demographics and Pensions Research for the Investment Banking Division of Credit Suisse in London. Let's give a big hand to Dr.
Peter Drucker is called the biggest management guru of 20th century by Harvard and Stanford, who have their own management gurus. In 1976, Peter Drucker predicted GM, Chrysler, Ford, and all defined benefit pension plans in the world would go bankrupt. America did not take it seriously. Why? Because they got seduced by two McKinsey consultants who wrote a book called In Search of Excellence. And in Search of Excellence, seven excellent companies were supposed to be very, very good. They happened to be all American. But unfortunately, those seven excellent companies failed on a very, very big test. So let's assume that Petri is the GM CEO and Nicholas is the GM CFO. And I went to work for them in the 80s. Every defined benefit pension plan in the world and every corporate in the world made the mistake of not asking the question which they should have asked. When they gave me a $1,000 salary increase in the mid-80s, they did not ask the question, when Amlan retires at age 65, how much does that $1,000 translate in terms of pensions and post-retirement health obligations? Today, the equivalent is $18,943 just towards my post-retirement health obligations. So every company which made long-term promises made these unsustainable promises. And in 2006, I told the European Commission, Greece will go bankrupt. I was probably the first person to say it in the European Commission. Why? Because Greece in 2006 revealed to me that on pensions promises, they made a promise which was 30% more than the richest country in the world, Luxembourg. Five times more than US. 2.5 times more than France. The data was there for the whole European Commission, but we chose to ignore it. Why? Because those promises were made to the people who devised policy. Most of them were civil servants and policymakers in Greece. So one of the messages I want to give you is, let's not make unsustainable promises. But the more important message is, demographics, when we do pay attention, we miss the point. Where does the word demographics come from? Demos, people, graphos, characteristics. What are the characteristics of these people sitting out here? The deputy mayor sits in a red tie, he sits in a blue tie, he wears a yellow tie. Not all of you are wearing white shirts. These ladies have different jewelries, they have different glasses. He wears a striped tie, which is very different than the striped tie at the back. All of us have very different consumer and work preferences. So as people, the biggest characteristic of us is not our age. Demographics does not equal age alone. That is the biggest mistake we make, saying it's age-related, it's predictable, it's long-term. The biggest thing to know about demographics is that we are consumers from the day we are born till the day we die. A two-hour-old baby in Helsinki, a 114-year-old man in Turku. They're both consumers. And on top of it, we consume differently and we work differently. So if I had to put a video cam, webcam on Minister Stubbs' desk and another video cam on the finance minister's desk, they might be doing equally important work, but they work differently. I work very differently than Petri does, or do other people in mandatum life work. We need to understand how different we are as workers and consumers. Let's assume all of you are clients of Credit Suisse. What are you then? You are potential revenue givers to Credit Suisse. And as a worker, I'm a cost. Revenues minus costs affect income statements and balance sheets at all levels. For an individual, for a household, and for all of us. Last week when I was in Hong Kong, last Monday, we published a paper. Why longevity matters to us all, and yet we don't understand it. It was a critique of governments, fund managers, investment banks, societies, and all of us. Because I'm going to ask you the question which no one has answered to me. I've asked it to 9 Nobel laureates. I've asked it to more than 10,000 CEOs. The question is the following. Minister Stubbs says, Amlan, you're age 65. You need to retire. Petri tells me, Amlan, you will die when you're aged 85. I'm the best life insurance company in the world. I know when you're going to die. And he's got an inside line to God. Okay? So 20 years is my post-retirement. How much money do I need for 20 years post-retirement? We are still using the old models of economics and finance based on Modigliani, Sharp, Samuelson, where retirement ages were only 4 years, 5 years. The retirement age of 65 was determined by Bismarck in 1892, when life expectancy in Germany was 46. Today, the average Finnish woman lives 83.6 years. 18 years beyond the retirement age, and the biggest challenge Finland faces is how to deal with it. Let me tell Minister Stubbs something that no one in Finland would have told him. At age 80 plus, Finnish women outnumber Finnish men by a ratio of 2.7:1. In Germany, the number is 2.9:1. So we need to deal with who is going to get affected a lot more by retirement. Let's look at the world. 80 plus population is the fastest growing population segment in the world. From 26 million, we go to 112 million from 1970 to 2012. As we take the world population from 3.7 billion to 7.1 billion. Most of these people are women, about two-thirds, one-third are men. Women outlive men by 6 to 8 years in the rich countries, and even in the poor countries by 4 to 5 years. So one of the key things I also want to highlight is Asia is in denial. 46% of the global 80 plus population is in Asia. And in Japan and in Korea, where I'm going to be in May, and I was there last November advising 23 governments, my message to Asian governments was, you are unprepared, you are in denial, and this is going to affect your growth. So better start doing things and learning from mistakes of the West. Next thing is, let's look at emerging markets. Fertility rates, children per woman in emerging markets is going down from 4.2 to 2.6. Life expectancy is increasing from 60 to 68. Linda, can you make sure that Minister Stubbs has a copy, please, of the presentation? Or you can take my copy from the thing. So what we are trying to show out here is that from lower levels of life expectancy, poor countries are growing older faster, 60 to 68 versus 73 to 78. Poor countries are having fewer children. 4.2 to 2.6, relative to rich countries, 1.9 to 1.7. So from low levels of aging, emerging markets or developing countries are aging rapidly, something that CNBC, CNN, Bloomberg forget to tell you when they say, just go towards emerging markets. I've been doing emerging markets since I was 16, worked with World Bank, IMF, lots of governments, and I can tell you, based on this, that not everything is rosy. The rosy part is the lower part. And that tells you that rich countries will have population growth turn negative from 2020. That means population growth will go negative, population will decrease, consumers will decrease, workers will decrease. That's where emerging markets comes in terms of greater number of consumers, greater number of workers. Germany is the first country in the world where population started decreasing. Can anyone tell me the date? Because the FT economics editors don't get it right. It was 1970 onwards, German deaths have been greater than births. Only migration kept German population positive. Today, when migration is coming down, Germany has no alternative but to export. Nearly 50% of German GDP comes from exports. So we need to understand those things. And the next slide shows you the four solutions. We advised 19 governments on migration, pensions, health, and taxes. And this was our policy prescription in the year 2000. This got debated in the French Parliament in the year 2000-2001. Four solutions are flexibly enabled retirement, which means that when Nicholas, Petri, or Amlan retire, or Anne retire, we don't go from 50 hours of work down to zero. We go part-time, part-year, part-week. And we abolish mandatory retirement ages. Your neighbors in Nordic land, in Norway and in Sweden are linking retirement ages to longevity. That's a prudent way to do it, but that isn't the only way to do it. We need to have flexibly enabled retirement because maybe this gentleman out here, Charles, is fitter than I am. You want me to work at 70, but I've been working in a mine all my life, whereas he's been a professor working for the Ministry of Finance. So you need to think about these things holistically. And the second solution which challenges you is we need to increase female labor force participation rates. The gap between male and female labor force participation rate today in Japan is 23%, Italy 22%, Finland 8.9%, Sweden 8.3%, United States 13%, and the country I come from, one of the worst, India 52%. In all these countries, every country has the potential to bridge the gap between males and females because females live longer than males, and at age 18, Finnish girls are doing better than Finnish boys, Swiss girls are doing better than Swiss boys at school leaving exams. So this is something which is untapped talent. You cannot address the situation by looking at migration without unleashing women power and the potential of women. Because every country in the world, including Finland, except for two, US, Norway, Sweden, Netherlands, Denmark, or UK, all of you got immigration wrong because you treated it like a political policy debate without asking fundamental economic questions. How many immigrants do we need? Which skills? For how long? Can women do the job? What are the costs? What are the benefits? Australia.